Right, guys, I've got the race organizer of the Addo Trail Run with me. Sean, thank you so much for chatting to me. You've had quite a hectic weekend.
Oh, you've got no idea. Oh, my goodness, yeah. Do you know, to pull a race like this together takes a hell of a lot of logistics. We're in the middle of nowhere here, you know. When you're putting people through a course that is 161 kilometers in length, and to get simple things like just putting water out that they can drink at water points. We trucked 4.5 tons of water out into the middle of nowhere. That has to be loaded by hand onto a 4x4, driven out 2 hours at a time to the different checkpoints, driven back, load again. Just those little logistics are quite critical. And we had a couple of big spanners thrown in the works. You know, we start our organization roughly a week before the race, purely because of the time it takes to put these things together. And last weekend we had significant rainfall here, which for the park is fantastic. I mean, we're in the middle of a big drought. So yes, every raindrop we can get, we hold on to with dear life, you know. And but what that does to me is it threw my entire schedule out by 3 days. I can't get into the places I need to get into because it's too wet. So everything got thrown back onto the back foot, and we had to work long and hard. I was getting up at 5 in the morning, going to sleep at 1 in the morning for 3 days straight, just to get those things into place so that we had a race course set up, marked and ready for the race this weekend.
Absolutely, it's no mean feat. And obviously, with having a race of this magnitude and you've got the three different distances, obviously safety is an issue.
Yes.
You know, can you just tell our viewers out there how you put these things together, the safety precautions you take and everything?
Sure, okay. Safety is a critical component of it. We have an extremely, extremely good medical crew, number one. The medical crew is very, very important. But they have to be highly specialized. So we use ECMR as our medical crew. They work with us in all of our events. They are properly kitted for events like this. They have 4x4 ambulances. We have mobile medics on quad bikes and scramblers that are out there. The medics are fit. They can run into difficult areas if they need to. We have mountain rescue on standby. Last year we had to call in a helicopter medevac on top of the mountain because somebody fell and cracked her pelvis. So the safety net is there, and we need to make sure that we can get every athlete home safely. So that is it's a critical component of it. And we work with the best in the business. So that's and they're local too, which is obviously the best part of it.
Definitely. Now, with you guys being a local, being a PE-based event organizer, I believe the Addo Trail Run, the 100-miler, is part of the world circuit. That is quite an achievement for you guys. Can you just tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. Okay, so when we brought the distance back, we wanted to kickstart 100-mile running in South Africa. And one of the things that you do to attract, I guess, the international runners and to make it an attractive race for guys to come and do is you look to see what other races it could possibly be part of. The pinnacle of trail running, especially in the ultra distance racing scene, is the Ultra Trail Mont Blanc, okay, UTMB. We have joined forces with the International Trail Running Association. We've had all of our courses are certified by them, and any athlete that completes one of our races can earn points to qualify them to run UTMB. So that is a big step up for us. We were the first 6-point UTMB qualifier with the 100 miler, and the nice thing about what we've seen in the growth of the sport in South Africa is we've brought Addo, that distance back to Addo, and within the space of, I think, of about 2 years, we now have another 400-mile races all on the trail scene. Every single one is completely different, but they're all on that same kind of level of challenge and achievement, you know, so yeah, that's what it's about.
Absolutely. And we also had quite a large contingency of PE runners participating and some people doing magnificent or achieving magnificent things. Can you just tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. You know, this year for me, the 100 mile was the ladies' race. You know, and this is the fourth edition that we've had of it. And we've never had more than 5 girls in the previous 3 years. In 2 of those 3 years, we've never even been able to give out a third place trophy because the girls didn't finish. This year we had 18 girls, and 2 out of the 3 on the podium were from Port Elizabeth, and we had a new course record, a sub-24-hour 100-miler by Annalise Scholtz. I'm so proud of her. I cannot tell you. My heart is just like, wow, that's amazing.
Absolutely. Now we're all very, very proud of all of them and of you guys. And tell me, obviously, with this race being part of the international sort of circuit, you had quite a few international runners here.
Yes, we did. Our new title sponsor, Hoka, sent one of their top trail athletes over to race. He didn't race the 100 miler, he raced the 76k distance, but he wanted to come over and try and fight it out with Ryan Sands, and they batted out quite a big duel, you know. Ryan thankfully beat him, and it's always good to have local boys on the podium, but but Aurelien put up a good fight, coming in with a very close second. And yes, you know, we had athletes from 17 countries here this year, so it has a wide international appeal. I mean, who wouldn't want to come and run in a game reserve? The only game reserve that has the Big Seven. So that's one of the really, really special things about Addo. It is a beautiful place, and for us to be able to showcase it like we do on the international scene is just a fantastic opportunity and quite an honor.
Absolutely, and you guys are amazing ambassadors for South Africa, for Port Elizabeth, and also for conservation, and for that we absolutely love you guys. Now, what is next for Live Adventure?
Next for Live Adventure, we have quite a few different events that we do. Our next big adventure is the Nanaha Mountain Bike Race, funnily enough, which is one of the biggest single-day mountain bike races in the Eastern Cape. We have, I think, over 1,000 riders that come and take part in that. And that also showcases another little special part of the Eastern Cape. Everybody knows about Nanaha Pies. Now they get a chance to ride in the area that all of that comes from. So that is also fantastic. And we have another one of our trail runs is in a separate part of Addo, the Woody Cape section. It's the Alexandria Trail Run. That's happening in late July, if I'm not mistaken. And that is a race also. It has a real special attraction. People get to experience the Alexandria dune field, the beautiful dune forests that are out there. That's also a very special race. So if they're looking for another trail run, book it. Have a look, alexandria.run, and they'll be able to see where to go.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to chat to me. We absolutely love your events. They're well organized. They are scenic. They're beautiful. So keep doing what you guys are doing.
We will. We do. We love it too. So thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Only a pleasure. Hi guys, we are back at the Addo Elephant Trail Run, and I've got Steve Lancaster with me, who ran for the Ollie Foundation. Steve, congratulations on completing 100 miles.
Thanks very much. It was lots of fun.
Okay, other words come to mind, but we'll leave that for a later date. Now tell me, Ollie, what is Ollie all about?
At One Land, love it. Essentially, you're looking at legacy. You know, what's going to be left behind when we're gone? And is it going to be there for our kids? If it's not something that's going to help, it's going to be something that's going to take things away. And I've been very fortunate to walk 20, 30 meters from these magnificent creatures in the wild. I have kind of been more than about 10 years old. I want my kid to have the same experience. Hopefully a little safer than I had, but yeah. One Land Love It does a hell of a lot of work for anti-poaching and for orphaned rhinos. There was never a doubt about my support for them. I'm actually supporting three other charities as well. Herald Christmas Cheer Fund, Rainbows and Smiles, which is a kids' cancer charity. And I know there's one other one, the Community Vets Association, that takes care of stray dogs, cats, and township owners who can't afford to take care of their pets, but they're responsible and loving parents. So, you know, if people are going to be making a difference in the world around them, we want to support them. And that's what it's all about.
That is absolutely magnificent. Now, I'm curious. It is wonderful to support all of these causes, but how do you train for 100 miles of off-road running?
You just don't stop. So, you know, you've got to run and run. You've got to train in similar kinds of terrain that you're doing. You've got to have a great team around you. My family has been superb in allowing me some time to do it, because I can't do it during work hours. but I've got a great work as well in terms of the fundraising aspect. Guys who are donating to Razor Bar, which is the whole campaign, RAZEABAR. So that if you're donating through Back a Buddy to that, there's a number of prizes you can win: Belega socks and Cellu City hamper. There's a phone and battery pack and something else in the prize. Just to encourage folk to donate. So, you know, to have the team around me, supporting me, loving me, pushing me on, makes it impossible to stop.
Absolutely. Now, Steve, obviously we love your work and we want to continue supporting you. So just this campaign, obviously it's ongoing, right? So just for the viewers out there, again, how do we get hold of you? How do they donate?
Yeah. Back a Buddy go and search Razor Bar, again R-A-Z-E, a bar. And the name actually comes from, you've got to get rid of the, what you think you can do. You know, sometimes you think you can't run 5Ks, well, walk. sometimes you think you can't run 100, well, walk. And that's 100 miles is more about walking than running. But you can follow the whole campaign also on Facebook. So again, Razor Bar, R-A-Z-E, a bar.
Fantastic. Well, well done once again on this amazing achievement, and people, support the cause. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Sharon. I appreciate it. And yeah, lots of love.
Right, guys, I'm with the winner of the 100-mile Addo Trail Run. Annalise, congratulations. What an amazing feat.
Thank you very much, Sharon. That was quite a tough day out.
I can imagine the heat was absolutely insane. How was the conditions out there?
The first, like the evening was also very humid. Everybody told us it will cool down, but it never did. So it was hot the whole evening, and it was just hot from like 5 o'clock in the morning. It was already boiling. Yeah, the last from about 12 o'clock, it was almost unbearable. It was really, really bad.
Shame, man. Well, in spite of these conditions, these really hot, humid conditions, you still managed to not only be the first lady in, but you broke the record by 10 minutes and you were the second person to cross the finish line. Did you set out to do this?
No, it was just, I just wanted to finish it. Like, the whole thing was just, it was my first 100 miler and I just wanted to enjoy the experience and finish. That was my main aim.
Well, that is absolutely phenomenal. And might I add, this is a PE native, a PE lady. So congratulations. We are so proud of you.
Well, guys, we hope that you enjoyed the Addo race as much as we did. And we hope that you are as inspired as we are. What an amazing event. What amazing athletes. But guys, the action doesn't end here. Catch us next week, same time, same place, right here on Go Well with Sharon. Bye.